Interventional oncology is a relatively newborn field, and what we do is essentially provide minimally invasive therapies of different cancers, most frequently liver, lung, and kidney cancer.
The advantage of these methods is that they have much less effect on the rest of the body, and also they have lesser effect even on the surrounding organ.
Liver cancer, it is in a way a very unique disease. It is one of the diseases that has been increasing in incidence rates as opposed to most other cancers. In cancer care, all the decisions ultimately are being made in tumor boards.
There's a host of members who come together who can weigh in on what they feel is the most appropriate management for any particular patient. There's a lot of data that needs to be put into play in terms of making a recommendation on how to manage a patient. What do the blood work look like? How healthy are they in terms of other medical conditions they may have?
Published information that pops up at an incredible speed.
What does their imaging look like? How many tumors?
Multiparametric imaging data.
How aggressive does the tumor look like?
Tumor markers, genomic information.
The size of the tumor.
History.
That can become quite complex.
We identify a clinical problem where we are overwhelmed with a certain set of data and approach the biomedical engineers and say, hey guys, you are much smarter than we are. How can we come up with a solution? How can we come up with an algorithm that is going to help us through this chaos of data?
We look to the clinicians to give us the appropriate clinical questions. Then we try to develop algorithms that would address those issues. We gather data from them along with their expert annotations and background information. And then it's an iterative process of testing these algorithms, evaluating how well they're performing, and back and forth.
Yale offers the ideal infrastructure with those experienced PhD-level faculty, biomedical engineers, computer scientists who have been doing this work for the last three decades, and us who now have, on a clinical end, a big interest in really advancing that field and introducing it into a clinical practice.
These algorithms detect patterns in clinical data that are then used for decision-making with respect to treatments.
In liver cancer, imaging plays a very, very important role, and this is where we need to really get better at extracting the imaging information in a quantitative way.
It's an advanced tool that, just like all the other tools in the physician's toolkit, this is another one. It's based on algorithms instead of a stethoscope.
Humans aren't perfect. And machines aren't going to be perfect either, but maybe putting the two together will achieve a greater level of perfection.
I think that deep learning and deep learning-based algorithms can help us devise a decision support tool that will make the tumor boards more effective and actually make our clinical outcomes better for the patients.